Well, what's up, everybody? CJ Harris here with the Motostop Show. I brought a good friend back in studio, a longtime friend, a longtime supporter, a longtime sponsor of mine, Mr. Carl Rutledge himself. Woo! Welcome back, Carl.
Yes, sir. I can't wait to get this thing going, buddy.
Well, let's just talk a little bit. How you been?
Man, I've been doing great. We've just been hanging out at some of the local races, all the grassroots races. All the kids out there having a good time with them, you know. We went to Atlanta, Tristan Lane, tried to take a swing at the arena cross boys. Got swung right at through the whoop-de-doos, man. He had some chaos going on down there. But, man, I've had so much fun doing the motocross thing, man.
Yeah, it's cool. Hey, and just so we're still doing our YouTube, this is a regular Motostop show. But something we're trying out tonight is we have Facebook Live. We see everybody on here jumping on. We're already getting a lot of viewers so far, so you guys keep going. We've seen Trace Lane. We were just talking about Tristan Lane. Trace Lane's on there.
He killed it on the mountain bike course.
They both won.
Tristan got second, but he won his class in the mountain bike race right there at Gatorback. Razorback, I'm not sure what it's called. I've never done the mountain
Diamondback.
Bike stuff there. Diamondback. But he killed it there, man. So shout out to you, Trace, man. We love you, bro.
Yeah, a lot of people. Jake Rakes is on. John Touchton, I seen Chris Ware, all the way from California, already on here. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy it. We're going to talk a little bit about the pros, what's been going on. C-Rudd is posting up right now. There you go. He's getting us live, going right there on his Facebook page. So we're going to talk a little bit about the racing that has been. It's been a few weeks since we've had a show going on, but we're super stoked to be back, and it's not because we didn't have anything to talk about, but it's just been, you know, we've been so damn busy with, like Carl said, a lot of the local races, Loretta Lynn's amateurs coming up, with my job, and then we had Daytona Supercross. Those of you guys don't know, Daytona Supercross has been, you know, a big event for the Motostop and the Motostop Show. We had great plans to go there and film live this year, and everything looked to be going good, but right at the last minute, they shut us down on the press passes, so we couldn't actually do what we intended. But next year, as we continue to grow, as you guys continue to grow with us, we'll probably be there trackside, hopefully filming, and before you know it, they're not even going to be watching Fox Sports, they're just going to be watching the Motostop Show, bro.
That's right, man. We're trying, man. You know what I mean? CJ, you've been doing a great job. It's getting better and better every week. I appreciate everything you do for all of us, and you know, you and the whole family, everything you do, man. You, Big Deal Productions, you know. I mean, what more can we do for you guys? You know, it's up to you guys now to make us take it to the next level, you know. When y'all increase all of our views, it helps us out, you know. And all of y'all looking on, look at old Brian Tipton there. BBTNX rules.
Donnie Shive jumped on. My father jumped on. So we can see everything you guys are doing on there. So if you have a question, Chuck Harris. That's the original C. Woo! Harris right there in the house.
CJ.
Taco Shack, Team Taco Shack's on there. Burn Rubber Car, I don't know what he's talking about, but
we were burning rubber at the bike night there for Beach Boulevard Motorsports. You know, we kind of set off the parking lot there for a little while. They didn't have anything going on. I figured we needed to light up some tires, so we lit them up for the BBTMX and Beach Boulevard Motorsports over there at Buffalo Wild Wings a little bit ago on the way over here to Big Deal Production Studios. So
we've had
some fun today.
So let me just start off, and this is going to be a little weird show, I guess, tonight, because it looks like Facebook's a little more interactive. So we Donald Soley, outdoor team. I know someone for hire. Donnie's looking for a job.
Ew, Soley could rip that
Ingram's
thing.
Ingram's on there. They just continue to go on. Longtime friend Sean Page right there. I got to give a big shout out to Big Deal Productions. You know, these guys have been backing me with whatever kind of idea I come up with. Sometimes they're a little more crazy than others. But literally, I give him an idea, and he goes, hey, I said, why don't we go live on Facebook? I show up to the studio tonight. They have it all set up, ready to go. So I couldn't do anything I do, you know, whether it's media, at the tracks, without the support of Big Deal Productions. So make sure you guys go out, support anything and everything they do. Follow them on YouTube. Subscribe. We have a few different channels now. We have the Motostop Show channel. We got Big Deal Production channel. Anything you guys see, they're doing something really cool. Even if you're not into moto, I mean, they do something called the production life, got cameras and stuff going on, and just check it out. So, Nate Ingram, yeah, you get a shout out too. David Shooter Brown, we'll
pass to Nate.
All right, so
Shooter.
You know, I got to thank Carl Rutledge. Like I said, he's been a longtime supporter of mine. I mean, he keeps me fresh to death in all the coolest Ruthless gear. He's definitely a brand that supports the sport out there. Make sure you guys check it out, Live Ruthless, for all the latest and greatest product. Whether you want a hat, a fresh shirt, everything you got, Carl. What's new in the pipeline for Live Ruthless?
We've got some kids stuff coming up. I've got a couple designs coming out for the kids. Look for that in the future, maybe the next couple weeks or something. We'll get to the print shop and get those things taken care of. We got some stickers coming out for the kids, and it's all about the kids, man. I mean, I just do it for the kids. I love them so much. And
well, and the fishermen, you got
fishing's taking off. So we're moving right along.
Hey, we got FMG on here, Florida Motocross Group. Really cool group out there that goes out and throws down on all the tracks. They're famous for their whip contest.
Oh, look at that, CJ. Florida Georgia Series coming up. Not this weekend, next weekend.
We're going to get
Orlando
into that a little bit.
Orlando Motocross.
Absolutely. April 2nd, Orlando MX is the place to be. It's going to be all the hottest racers out there. Huge gates. The fastest of the fastest in Florida right there. Florida Georgia Championship, Florida MX Motocross Series right there.
Orlando MX. There's
it's
nothing
be
better.
Huge. So, hey, before we continue on, we're going to talk a little bit about amateur racing, and I got to do a little bit of that in Daytona. But I just want to continue with a few more sponsors, some big sponsors that helped me out a long time. HBD, Moto Graphics, couldn't do what I do without you guys. Support my racing habits. I can't call it a career, racing habits. FMF, you know, they've been behind me for a long time, all the way back to my stunt bike days. We have Everrev. Loudmouth Intakes. If you guys don't know own a Loudmouth Intakes, make sure you check out loudmouthmx.com.
That's Sunoco, baby.
Yep, Sunoco.
The fuel of champions right there.
We'll talk a little bit about that here coming up in Daytona. And absolutely, Nate, we can't forget about Motocross of Marion County this weekend.
World-famous
Reddick, Loretta Lynn's qualifier.
That's right. It's on at Reddick, man.
Carol
Blackburn's going to throw down, I can assure you that. That track will be mint.
It will be.
You know, Travis will be out there grooming. It'll be great. Is it a kids qualifier?
Area qualifier.
Area. Okay. Anybody. All right. Yeah. So, man, it's going to be a great event out there. You guys make sure you attend Reddick. They're only open a couple times a year. It's the only time you can go shred that beautiful dirt she's got down there. The Blackburn family doing such a great job. You guys make sure you get down there and support that great motocross family down there at Motocross of Marion County.
Absolutely. Well, let's talk a little bit about the pros, man.
Woo!
Dude, the racing has been hot.
Tomac, man. It's Tomac.
It is.
That's all I can say, man. That kid's been ripping. Osborne on the 250. It's been an Osborne show. So, man, when we get back to West Coast, though, what's going to happen? When are we fixing to flip that up?
I don't know. I got so much to catch up with because I haven't had a show in a few weeks. So, we got to backtrack. Let's rewind this thing for just a second. Let's talk about Hotlanta.
Oh, that was awesome. Atlanta was a great race.
Atlanta always has. And for those of you guys who don't know, I used to live up in North Georgia, and Atlanta was one of my stomping grounds. And I went with my family multiple, like, we went every year until I moved away. And unfortunately, my little brother and my mom actually got to go down there this year, which they had a sick time. I tried to fly up there. I had some other obligations, so I couldn't make it. But, yeah, you were there.
It was awesome. And they called it MotoFest. They did arena cross racing. They did amateur arena cross racing, arena cross racing, and then pro supercross racing. And it was like the event of a lifetime. It's a little stretched out. Like, I won't lie to you. You need a golf cart. You need a scooter. You need something. Me, mom, and dad had a horrible time getting from the pit back to the event, back and forth. Other than that, it's the most epic event I've ever attended in my life. It was just awesome. You got to see your little rippers go out there. You got to see Tristan and the pros go out there and just battle it out, Gurky and the boys. And then the next night, you got to see the pros come out there. Well, what arena cross does so differently than supercross is they do a pit party. They had everybody, all the pros, on the track. Well, this time they incorporated the Supercross pros. So this time you had an intimate experience with Ryan Dungey. You know, you had like an intimate experience with Eli Tomac. I mean, I saw kids completely just hanging out with them. It wasn't like a pit experience where you were, you know, quarantined off to the rider and he's basically just reaching over at the stall. No, Eli Tomac was in the crowd with the kids, hanging out. Dungey in the crowd, hanging out with the kids. It was epic.
That's legit. So do you see something like this in the future, you know, happen again? Now, this was the last year in the Georgia Dome.
Yeah, they'll incorporate it into that new dome, I'm sure. I mean, they got a beautiful facility. I believe it's like the Mercedes-Benz Stadium or something like that. And it's going to be better. You know, it'll be probably a better event when they switch over there. But what I'm sure Arena Cross is going to catch on to is that they need to incorporate these events together like they did on that, because that was such an awesome experience to be down on the course with all of the who's who of motocross in that, you're on the track in a pit party with those guys. You got a concert going on, the Monster Girls, everything on the track. We were on the track jumps with the pros.
Yeah, that's sick. And hopefully they do, because I can tell you this year it kind of screwed up. Most of you guys know I made a run at the arena cross last year and, you know, was able to qualify while still doing all the local amateur stuff and running the Motostop as well. But this year, they had the New Orleans round was on the same weekend as Daytona, so a lot of us couldn't make both rounds out there. So it kind of sucks. So hopefully AMA will get together, or FEL will get together with AMA, and they will figure this thing out.
Yes.
And get it figured out. But not only was the track hot, the racing in Atlanta was pretty hot too, man, wasn't it?
It was intense. It was so intense, man. The 250 racing, the heat races, the LCQs, the arena cross racing, even the kids racing. The kids racing was incredible. Some of these guys that, you know, they're maybe not better at some of those stretched out tracks. We got them on those little tight tracks.
Right.
You get a good hole shot. Now you've got the kid that normally finishes fourth up front. So it was awesome to see, man. It was awesome.
Well, let's talk a little bit about Daytona. 2 weeks back. Now, I listen to a lot of social media, a lot of podcasts, a lot of media guys out there. And, dude, I'll tell you what. These people have been knocking this Daytona race, that how bad it sucks. And, you know, now, we're going to get into the track here in a second. But I know me and you've spent the last few years there together.
Yeah, Rob, we've raced on it.
Yeah, I don't know about you, but I think Daytona is one of the funnest.
It's the awesomest experience ever. I mean, how could it not be?
Almost like MotoFest, it is Moto Week. So you kick it off and you have your practice, your qualifying press day on Thursday. Friday, you got your practice. Saturday, you got your qualifying. You go into your pro night. Sunday, you have your your amateur. Monday, amateur. Tuesday, you go into your four-wheelers. Thursday, they have the TT race right there in the middle of the track. The next weekend, you have the Daytona 200. And as we talk about this, man, we got a lot more people coming on. I just seen my beautiful wife jumped on there. So I imagine Moto Harris is probably...
Moto!
What's up, buddy? Moto, give us a thumbs up on the camera thing if you're there. Martin, hey, you know what? There he goes. There's a thumbs up.
Little Moto.
Hey, Martin Cox from Super Cool Bike Shop out there Gainesville. Another guy that's helped me out, hooked me up. If anything you guys need for bikes, make sure you check him out.
Oh, he's got some nice stuff.
He does. I love my Specialized, so a big shout out to Super Cool Bike Shops right there. Back to Daytona, though, man. It's a race that I couldn't really miss. And you go there.
It's bike week.
It's bike week.
How can you miss Daytona?
You
can't miss Daytona. My parents went out and bought bikes for Daytona.
They did.
Both of them. They went last year. You know, did the bicycle thing. They found out they could ride bikes. They went this year. They made sure we had bikes before we went to Daytona. My mom got a scooter. Dad got a street bike. Took the Harley. We had a great time. Iron Horse. Come back to the racing. See qualifying. Watch nighttime racing. Get up in the morning. Watch kids racing. There's nothing better than Daytona. If you had a bad time at Daytona, it's on you.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? It's on you. You don't know how to have a good time.
I mean, Mama and Papa Ruthless are just ruthless to begin with.
Yes.
So they're going to have a good time.
Yes.
But that's what I'm talking about, like the pit parties. I mean, you don't have that in Atlanta. You don't have people camping out and hanging out for days upon days and go around and find a different party.
Two weeks.
Dude, it's epic.
The TT racing.
Was sick.
Oh my gosh. The singles TT race was so awesome. And I came back to town and I talked to a guy and he had a flat track shirt on. I said, man, did you see that? He goes, oh, it was horrible. And I said, were you there? And he said, no. I just saw the comments online. And I said, man, that was the funnest race I think I've ever seen. The singles race was amazing. You had to be there, I guess, you know?
Yeah.
You had to be there. It was awesome.
And somebody's going to be mad at me. You guys might know him, Dean Diaz Jr. Woo! Out of Orlando MX.
He said it was boring.
Did he?
He told me it was boring. I go, Dean, you didn't stay there long enough. Did you see the singles race?
That's probably because I didn't go. Okay.
Oh, it was so fun.
I was supposed
to
meet him there, but I had to work late and I didn't get a chance, so I didn't go. And he gave me the thumbs down. So.
Oh, I love flat track racing. It's so awesome.
Well, let's talk about the Supercross.
Yes.
A little unorthodox track than what we're accustomed to in Supercross world, but we understand that. So it's more, some say outdoor style. You got some peaky jumps. I get it. It's a little different.
Yeah, it all, you know, Daytona always is. But you got Ricky Carmichael, the god of motocross, designing that thing. It's not like Ricky doesn't know how to get around a track. It's not like Ricky doesn't know how to flow. That thing was awesome. It provided awesome racing. The starts were awesome.
The start was good.
You know, I like the track. I thought it was awesome. I didn't ride on it. I understand that it's rough, and yeah, it's outdoorsy, but it always is a Daytona. It's always a different race at Daytona.
I may have a little different opinion on this.
What do you got, CJ?
So, and I get it. Ricky Carmichael, you know, one of the best riders of all times, right? Yes. Out there, okay? Some call him the GOAT. He has limitations when he's building this track, obviously, with the speedway.
Tri-oval.
Yeah, the tri-oval, well, you got to watch out for sprinkler heads. You also, they make him watch out for speed on the track. So a lot of those switchbacks, S-turns, are all put in there because of
the Francis family
who owns the Speedway, Daytona Speedway, requires that. Now, I think the track was great, but I don't think it led to the racing that we could have seen out of such an epic dirt. The dirt in Daytona is amazing.
Yeah.
The facility is amazing. Daytona didn't have the whoops it usually does. Other than that, I like the changes from Alex Dunby all the way over the west coast of Florida. Don't get confused. Hey, hold on. I got Chris Narden on there. You guys don't know Narden, but that is one of my first sponsors in the sport bike world. When I first moved down here, Narden took care of me. He built everything on my bike. Absolutely amazing. He's moved on to a different career now in the Coast Guards, but huge shout out, Chris, to everything you did for me back in the day. So the racing out there, back to it. I mean, obviously Tomac had the track covered.
Yeah,
was
dominant.
Sick.
He's dominant.
What right about now. Jeremy Martin on the 450?
Woo! What a ride!
That kid,
what a ride!
On
I mean,
fire.
What more can you say? That kid was unbelievable. My dad even said, who is that kid? I'm like, he's a 250 rider. I never heard of him. Because dad, all weekend long, Dungy, you know, because Atlanta.
Yeah.
He saw Atlanta, you know, Dungy. Nobody can touch Dungy. I kept saying, you know, Tomac. Just watch Tomac. Miyamoto told dad all weekend long, Tomac. And, you know, that's what happened. But I think we really have some competition now. Don't think Dungy's counted out.
Dungy's not counting
no.
out. He's not counting
Never
out.
Never count him out. I keep telling Dad he's the diesel for a reason.
So
reliable.
234 points as we stand right here. And this is after Indianapolis. So we're after 11 rounds here in the Monster Energy Supercross Series. Eli Tomac, 222. So that's 12 points down.
Ooh, see, it's close now.
It is close.
He's edging up.
Marvin
no
Musquin, 185. Cole Seeley with 185 as well. Jason Anderson.
He's a ripper.
He is.
He is.
I kind of expected a little more out of him, I think. I mean,
He's solid,
but I think I expected him to win.
He reminds me of Dungy.
Yeah.
You know, like he's smart. He's a smart racer. You've got smart racers and you got on the edge racers. Tomac's an on the edge racer. Villopoto, on the edge racer.
Well, you know, to ride a Kawasaki, you got to be balls.
You got to be on the
race.
You got to ride the back wheel. You got to ride that back wheel, man.
Hey,
and he's starting to do that. He looks like Villopoto. He's entering the turns on the gas.
Full power, hang on,
yeah,
roll
it's
out.
It's amazing. Who else we got in there? Who's in the top five?
Well, that Jason Anderson rounds out the top five.
What about Marvin, man?
So I really feel like, you know, this would have been a closer race and
Marvin's a ripper
and tighter if he didn't get sick and have those bad weeks.
Okay, yeah, I didn't know
so,
about that.
So super sick, I believe Atlanta.
If he's riding that good sick, that's incredible.
Yes.
Wait till he's well.
He got 15th, I think, in one of those races. This just gives me the points. Let's see.
Because, man, he's really came along.
All right, so Toronto, he got 8 points. And Daytona, he got 6 points. So he was pretty far back. But then he comes out in Indianapolis to get second for 22 points. Yeah.
Yes.
So, yeah, definitely, you know, somebody to watch out. And the 450 class is just, you know, at the beginning of the series, it looked like it was going to be a runaway. Dungy had this thing wrapped up.
Yes.
But as the series starts rolling on and we get deeper into this, man, it just starts to get more intense.
People get more comfortable. The teams start to gel.
They start figuring out the bikes.
You know, I mean, that's what's happening on Tomac's team. They're gelling.
Absolutely.
They're gelling over there, and it's all coming together. I'm sure they got Villopoto over there getting that thing going. I know they brought him on board. Jeremy McGrath's helping the team. You know, it's all coming together. You got world champions like that helping you out.
Well, well, the interesting thing about Villopoto, he's not really helping Kawasaki.
What's he? Is he fixing a switch out?
Well, I don't think he's switching up, but most of you guys probably don't know, he actually in Daytona was working for Jeremy Martin.
Really? He's a trainer. He's going to be a trainer.
Well,
now?
I don't know a trainer, but Martin brought him in to get some, you know, some suggestions, some ideas to take the track walk.
Well, it worked out, didn't it?
God,
dog.
So he did the track walk. He was on.
That was one heck of a ride. I thought he was going to win the race,
dude.
I thought he was going to win.
You know what? I think if he had more time on the bike and more time on the tracks, he definitely would have joined, or he definitely would have won.
It's a testament to that new Honda for sure.
It is.
To me, that's it's a testament to that Honda. That's a bike, man.
Whole shot machine.
It's a shame what happened to Roczen.
Dude, people just keep jumping on and jumping on. I don't know if you guys can see that out there in the Facebook world, but a longtime friend, Jeremy Warren, I mean, I've known that kid since I was this high up there in Georgia. Tavolacci from Dominic's Deli, where I stopped for lunch. They always take care of me out there. Dave Washington, that's Kristen Washington's father right there, jumped on. So we got a lot of our friends and family out there supporting us, and we guys hope you guys enjoy this. Give you a little rundown of what tonight's show. We're going to be on live as we talk about the pros and what's going on. We'll wrap up the show. Like I said earlier, this is still going to be our YouTube show. Make sure you check out all of our YouTube channels, the Motostop Show. You can find it on the motostopshow.com or YouTube and find out. But we're going to wrap this one up, and then we're going to get deeper into some amateur racing. We've been traveling and doing some amateur racing as well, so we're going to try to talk a little bit about that. But so coming up with the Supercross, back into the Supercross here. Next round, round 12, Detroit.
Oof. Kid Rock up and down the block.
Detroit City,
Oh, man, Detroit's always awesome. It provides for some real good racing.
It does.
Always, always. Maybe a Chad Reed. Come on, Chad Reed. Get up on that podium, buddy.
Hey, speaking
we wanted
of Chad
to see
Reed,
Chad Reed, man.
Did you see him in Daytona?
Yes,
loop
did
out.
I see him
loop
Daytona.
Out like
he was
straight.
Having one heck of a ride in Daytona, man.
Dude, he was. And then I'm not sure what happened, but he's straight just like, yeah.
Throttle.
You talk about Yamaha's got some power, son.
But, you know, just the love out to that guy, man. He is such an awesome guy. Brings the kids to the track. The kids cheer him on.
He does.
You know, if you hope to be a rider in motocross, it's Chad Reed. Emulate that guy. He's still out there banging bars, having fun. It seems like he's surpassed everyone that used to ride with him. He's still out there banging bars.
He has.
And what happened to Bubba? I thought Bubba was coming back, man. I cannot say something. Like, I thought we had a statement. Like, is it the last race of the year? What's going on with that, CJ?
Well,
you've got to have some insight.
I don't. Honestly, I don't. Geez. And about the only thing I got is the Pulp MX show said this week that he's thinking Monster Cup. He's going to come back.
Hey, I'm good. I'm good with anything he wants to do. Just please come back. Bubba, please come back.
Yeah, yeah.
Please. One ride, bro. One ride.
Even if it's not even to race.
Lay it off the back, bro. One lap. We just want to see you lead for a lap, bro.
Or just do some cool wheel taps. Or just send like a big ass jump.
We'll never forget Stewart, bro. Huh? I mean, the baddest dude ever, dude.
He is sick. But how about just come back to the race and like hang out, you know?
Yeah.
Walk around the pitch. Sign some autographs. I mean, the
bring
dude is
it.
Super cool.
Bring it.
Clermont, Florida. He could have made a trip down to Daytona very easily. And I've said it multiple times. Something really cool that I like about Bubba or James Stewart that most people don't know. You know, when he used to do a Supercross, he used to buy people's dinners. So Daytona, multiple years in a row, he would go to the Jensen Ale House and he'd say, hey, the first 100 people come in the door.
He's super cool.
I'm paying for their dinner.
Not only
was he paying for their dinner, he came and sat down and hung out with everybody in the crowd. You got somebody like James Stewart, he pulls up in his Ferrari and he jumps in and comes down, eats dinner, signs everybody's autograph. The guy's got time for days. I mean, he's got a race the next day, but he's there hanging out, enjoying life. We got to spend multiple nights with him there and hanging out and just disappeared.
Yeah.
From such a fan favorite to a friggin' Houdini? Is that the damn disappearing guy?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Come
friggin'
back,
Houdini.
Bubba, come back.
We need you.
We need you, Bubba.
We need you. All right, so Detroit is next up on the list. Could be a rutted track.
Yeah, it always is. It's a rough
track.
Track's
going to be pretty gnarly.
It's going to be gnarly.
Followed up, round 13, we're going to St. Louis.
Ooh, Louis.
STL. 314, baby.
That's a good one.
In case you didn't know.
That's always a good race as well. Detroit's a battleground, though. Detroit's going to be the race to watch.
It is.
Between Dungy and Tomac, you know, for the points. Anything can happen.
Do you think the motivation that Eli Tomac has right now, that Ryan Dungy has anything for him?
Not right now.
No.
Nope.
Dude, it is a steamrolling train.
Yes.
Dungy may be the diesel.
He's on another level.
But Eli Tomac is a freaking jet car.
But it's over the edge. It's
says who?
Says me?
Compared
I'm just
to
saying,
what?
Dungy rides the edge. He's not going to fall off the cliff. Tomac, he's hanging it out there. But that's what I love. That's what I love to see about a racer. That's why I like Tomac. He hangs it out there. I love to see a rider hanging out there.
All right, so
there's
wait.
Nothing better. Who used to hang it out there the best? Ricky Carmichael.
Wide
I used to
open.
See him hang off the bike everywhere. But you know what? At the end of the race, he'd be there in the front.
So, Chris, tell us what we don't know what we're talking about.
Jeffrey.
We see you. Chris Jeffrey.
He's got a new guy, apparently.
Famous father of Jessica and Nathan
Carrie,
Jeffrey.
We love you, Carrie.
Yep, big
Go
shout
Ryder
out to
Gwynn.
Carrie.
We can't wait for him to heal up, man. That's my hero. Ryder Gwynn,
number
dude.
Five.
That kid's the bomb. Bomb, bomb, bomb.
Wait, we're calling you out, Chris, and you're not even talking to us. All right, so
mark.
I definitely on my radar. I got Eli Tomac winning Detroit as well as St. Louis. I got to see you after two rounds. I know I'm making some predictions going in there. Marvin Musquin, I believe he's got the speed. He's over the sickness. So I'm putting him second place right now. I got Ryan Dungy.
I'm looking for Musquin. If Musquin is healthy, that kid is ripping.
Do you think he's on Tomac's
level? I didn't
level?
Even know he was sick. You told me he was sick.
Yeah.
I thought he was healthy.
No, he was sick pretty bad.
Oh, well, man, if he can put it together, Marvin Musquin, get a whole shot and check on out, my man.
Well, I mean, don't
Marvin Zip, what's he got?
he was healthy in Indianapolis, where he got second. I mean, he was getting like 15s when he was sick. So I think he was 100% healthy
wait.
And he didn't
I can't
have
wait
anything.
To see. Because, you know, Tomac, he's plagued with bad starts sometimes.
Not recently.
Not recently, but... You know, most of his career, he never gets that hole shot. He has to earn it. Every race, he has to earn his race. Earn his race, earn his race. So I'm thinking if Musquin can get that hole shot, Musquin may take it away for all of us.
Checking out.
Woo!
All right, I can go with that.
And Reed, I want Reed to be on the podium.
Yeah,
come on,
he's got to be.
Reedy, come on, man.
So something I want to talk about a little bit about Indianapolis. Did you see with Osborne and Cincerillo?
Yes.
What did you think of it?
It was a battle. Osborne.
No, well, in the practice. So I should refrain. So in the practice. So they come out. Osborne jumps out. Cincerillo comes in a little hot and gives him a bump. Okay.
Supercross?
Yeah, but it's in practice. So I see it was kind of a little over-aggressive. And about two turns later, and I'm going off memory. I haven't watched this in about a week or so. But two turns later, Osborne jumps into the inside and literally runs Cincerillo up over the berm. He fall and
just letting him know. He's just letting him know. He's just letting him know.
Practice.
Well, you know, hey, buddy, I'm Osborne, buddy.
Yeah, I get it. So Osborne is, you know, he's a badass. So
oh, yeah.
is AC.
Oh yeah.
But I think this is the problem with these young kids.
There's so much to show.
But
or they want to show. They
right.
have so much they want to show.
You're in practice, and I think and this goes back to a lot of the young kids that we know. You know, there's a time to shine, there's a time to figure stuff out.
That's right.
So if you're going out there and you're blowing out like this, going crazy on in practice, you may be getting injured. What if you don't even make the damn night show? What if Cincerillo, what if, say, Osborne came together and they both went down?
Vogel at Daytona.
Yeah, last chance qualifier, I didn't see what happened.
Vogel at him and some kid, they clacked each other, something happened. But, you know, it's like, whoa, you're definitely expected to be in there.
Yeah, done.
Done.
So you got to make sure, like I said, there's a time to shine and then there's a time to figure stuff out. So especially all the young kids, I know we got a lot of young kids on here right now watching the Facebook Live, but make sure practice, you know, make sure you take a sight lap out there around the track. Make sure you figure things out. You don't have to win practice.
No, back when I used to announce a lot, I would notice kids that weren't the dominant kid in practice, but they won the race. I used to call them smart racers.
Absolutely.
They're just smart racers. Jeff Lewis used to show up so hard like that. like in practice, 8th, 9th, 10th, mm-hmm. not even worried about practice. He would look at lines. He's looking like the pros do.
Yep.
Gator back gate drop, Jeff Lewis right out front, A-class, win that thing. Absolutely. Every time. You know, and I would go, that is such a smart racer right there.
Yeah.
He was just the smartest kid on his decisions. What he did, race day. Get the whole shot, check out, get my lines, set my lines, I win this race.
Yep. So, and just like John Bellini said right there, Adam Cincirillo did hurt his knee, his left knee, actually, in practice before this incident. And when Osborne came together, like I said, he didn't crash. He went off the track and actually ran into the gates. But when he stopped there at the gate, he had to jump off the right side of the bike and he couldn't put pressure on his knee.
Oh, yeah. Must have blew his knee out.
Yeah. So, I mean, injured, I think it's okay. I've heard reports that everything's good. So, no big deal there. But just stuff like that that kid can't afford right now. He's got to make it a season. He's doing so good. Solid. I think sitting fourth in the points. I don't have my sheets on the 250s. But, man, oh, man. And what about his ride at Daytona? We didn't even talk about the 250s at Daytona.
Oh, man, he did a good ride at Daytona.
Dude.
We were so proud of him. That was the one place he needed to win. He's been due a long time. Due.
He is.
That kid is expected to be the best kid ever. He did so much in his amateur career, and then when he came out pro, just bad luck, bad luck, bad luck, bad luck. Back to that smart racing.
That's it.
You know, you got to be a smart racer out here. And when you go to the pro level, you know, when he was an amateur, he was the standout kid. He could hold, he could walk away. He could get 20th, come back to first. You can't do that in the pros. There's that little gap of awesome, amazing riders, and they're all bundled together. And you really got to be on top of your game, and you've got to be very smart in your racing.
Absolutely. I couldn't have said it better. And I think that's what he's accomplished. You know, he set in at this season just to finish out the season. Those of you guys don't know, Adam Cincirillo, when he came out, he won 3 out of the first 5 races that he ever entered in Supercross. That is a crazy 60% success rate, winning rate, right there as an amateur in the 250 class. Unheard of.
Yeah, set the bar.
Set the bar so high that he couldn't finish it. Got hurt. And then he just starts falling down. Then, you know, he has a race. He comes back, and he can only race for one race and gets hurt again.
And it's the new crop of kids. You got these new kids coming up just as fast as you. Just as fast as you. Just as fast as you. You have all these trainers out here. Dean Dias, Matt Walker. I mean, we're training these kids to be, at 9 years old, they're champions.
They are.
World champions at 9 years old.
They are, for sure.
It's incredible. Jack Chambers, where you at?
Absolutely. There is a lot of trainers out here right now. You know, we actually had one on, Donald Tolley, on a little earlier. Not sure if he's still on there. The list goes on, and some phenomenal guys.
And that's what's happened to a guy like AC. You were dominant in your amateur career, and just that little bit of hesitation, boom, you got 4, 5, 6 guys that are your pace.
So do you see another win out of AC this year?
Yeah, he could. He could win. It's going to take a mistake by Osborne. Osborne's going to have to mess up.
Yep.
He's dominant of all those other. He's been, I don't know how many years, but he's been in the 250 class a long time. He's, in my opinion, ready to move up, but he's never had that season. You know, he's one of those kids that never put a season together to move on to the 450 class, basically.
So if you recall right, and I'm going off memory, Osborne went to overseas and raced some GNCC stuff over there.
He's an incredible racer.
He is. He's a good rider. So, yeah, I mean, he's been around, hell, probably damn near 10 years, I would say.
Yeah.
Was he 26?
Yeah, at the pro level. Yeah. You know, at the pro.
Yeah, but he did.
And you
take
got
off
these kids
time.
Coming in, you know, 2, 3 years. They're trying to get there, and you got, like, basically a solid pro. Yeah, a solid pro right there just hammering it to you. So, if somebody can beat him, accomplishment for sure.
Absolutely. Absolutely. All right, so who's your picks, top 5 for Detroit coming up? And it can't be Kid Rock.
It's going to be Tomac.
All right.
Moose Quain.
All right.
Dungy.
All right.
I'm feeling Tickle. I'm thinking Tickle and Baggett.
Tickle Baggett. All right.
Tickle Baggett, man.
They're up there.
Tickle's been ripping, man. Tickle's been putting it together. And I just want to see Ricky's team. You know, I want to see somebody from Ricky's team put it in there. I want to see Barsha. But I don't know what has happened to my man Bam Bam, but
he's off the rocker.
I would love to talk about him, but.
Well, let me just explain something about Ricky and Kerry Hart's team. So we were sitting there in Daytona, and we have kind of a tradition. You know, we get to really watch a race from anywhere, but now with industry seating and rider seating, it kind of sucks. So we always head back to the Budweiser tent, and we didn't even drink much. We just sat there and watched the race on TV, and we get to listen to the bikes and stuff. So Kerry Hart sits down right next to us, and he's watching the race. And, dude, it was so heartbreaking watching him try to watch the race, and he finally just had to get up and leave. So I hope something good happens. I mean, you go from such a high. You take Ken Roczen and win the championship with him. A privateer. Now, it is factory-supported team, but a privateer team, that's the RCH Kerry Hart team right there.
Yeah, they've got a team. They've got riders. They've got everything they need to get it together, but motocross is a tough sport, man.
You ain't kidding, bro.
It's not luck. It's half skill. It's half team. You know, it's a battle, man. It's a battleground.
And that's why we love this stupid sport.
It's not easy. It's not easy. There's nothing easy in motocross.
There's nothing. All right, so we got your picks. We're going to wrap up the pro section of here. Like I said, we hope you guys loved our Facebook Live. We've seen a lot of comments on there. You know, maybe we'll start doing this every week. I got to get the word back from the production company if this is feasible for us to do and if they liked it. And then if you guys like it, please leave us a comment. Like I said, make sure you share this thing. We're going to do another. We're going to wrap this episode up, and then we're going to go down into our amateur hour. So we're going to have an amateur power hour coming up very shortly. That's going to be our YouTube show, so make sure you check it out. We're going to hit all the hottest topics of what's going on, whether it's a Loretta Lynn's area qualifier, regional qualifier, Daytona Supercross, Freestone, everything that's going on out there. We're going to talk a little bit about it coming up in the amateur power hour. But right now, we're going to wrap up this pro section. Carl, as always, it's been fun bringing you into the studio.
Yes, for sure.
I couldn't do it without you. It's been real. It's been fun.
Orlando MX.
Orlando MX. Make sure you be there. B Square. David Madaros just joined us. Tracy Peavy, the whole Peavy family. April 2nd kicks off the open around Florida, Georgia, the Florida MX Series, where you get to come and hear this beautiful voice on the microphone only because this dummy gave me the microphone, gave me a chance on the microphone. He's like, hey, by the way, talk. And I didn't stop, haven't stopped shutting up yet.
No, man, you do a great job, CJ.
You won't hear me at Orlando MX.
Dean.
You're actually going to hear a Kawasaki that I'll be ripping. I'll be out there racing, but Dean Diaz.
I'm going to have to throw my leg over one.
You want me to bring you a green bike so you go fast?
No, I got one.
You got a blue bike. It doesn't go fast.
I'm ready to go on that thing, though.
I got a green bike.
I may ride this weekend, and then I'll be ready for Orlando in the next weekend. C-Rut may throw a leg over for the 40-plus.
Hasn't been on the bike in probably damn near a year.
Yeah, it's been a minute.
He says, I may ride this weekend, but I'll be ready for Orlando next weekend.
That's how you do it. That's training, bro. That's training.
Hey, we got Brandon Gibson on here from J3 Cleaners. You can check him out at j3cleaner.com. Yeah, man.
That's the best cleaner in the business,
you
J3.
Ain't kidding.
J3!
Right here, in case you can't see it.
Yes.
Bam! It does everything you don't want it to do. It cleans your bike. It does everything you don't want to do. I don't know.
No scrubbing. It's just loving.
That's right.
No scrubbing. Just pressure wash it off.
No scrub.
Actually, no pressure washer.
No pressure washer.
Straight hose.
Yep.
Little thumb.
We're going to wrap this one up.
All right. Pro.
Peace out, you guys.
Motostop.